So we are going to design this scene. In this scene, we are going to make a table and two vases and some flower and oranges. Okay, so this is the default cube. I am going to hide the camera and the light, and for this default cube, I am going to double click it and name it table. So everything is arranged. Okay, zoom and click this cube as to scale and scale it in Z direction. Something like that. Then select it as to scale and scale it in X direction. Like that. Okay. Now apply the scale which we apply. So when we apply the modifiers and do the editing, it will not affect it. So Control A to apply the scale. Every time when you use the scale, make sure to apply the scale by Control A and apply the scale. Select the object and Control A to apply it. Let me play the shortcut keys. Okay, now you can see the shortcut key here on the left corner, right corner. Okay, now this is the table. We are going to make a simple table. So go to modifier, and we needed to use the array to copy these cube and this range. These are the modifier, add modifier and select array. And we needed to make this in the X direction, in the Y direction. So make it X 0 and Y, we are going to increase it. Like that. So 1.2 will be good. Just try factor X, Y, and Z and see in which according to your in which side you are going to increase this factor. So you have the array. So we have the array, the count is 2, and here we can increase it. So 4, 5, 5 will be good for me. You can also increase it. Just make sure you are making it in the right direction. If we use the X, it will be like that. So make Z 0. For the X, it will be like that. So make X 0. For me, the Y is working. Okay. Now just apply this modifier. And we have a simple table like that. Okay. Now we have our 3D cursor here at this position. So everything which we are going to add will appear here. So Shift A, and we are going to add mesh. Go to mesh and we are going to add a cylinder. So like that. For the properties of this cylinder, go to left corner and maximize it. You can see we have 32 vertices and radius is 1. Minimize it. And now I am going to press 1 on numpad. So I have the front view, then G to move it and lock it in the Z direction by pressing the Z. So now it's will be like that. Okay. Now I am going to use this cylinder and make it a simple vase for the flower. Okay. Now press tab to go to the edit mode. And now you can see everything is selected. Then just click it, left click to deselect everything and then press 1 or press 3 to have the right side view. When you press the 3, you will on your numpad, you will have the right side view. Now if we select the top vertices like that, it will only select this half portion which we can see it. So to select all of these vertices in one selection, I am going to press 3 on numpad to go to the right side view, and then I have to activate the X-ray view. So Shift Z, by using the Shift Z, you can activate this X-ray. And now if I select, you can see I am selecting all of the top vertices. So press 3 and just Shift and middle mouse to zoom it, to pan it like that. And you can also activate this X-ray and the wireframe here like that. So Shift Z activate the X-ray and wireframe, and now select all of these top vertices. Make sure you are in the X-ray, and then G and Z to move it in Z direction and make it like that. Here we are going to scale this top vertices. So press S to scale it, something like that. Now we needed to extrude these vertices, so press E to extrude it and make sure your direction is locked in the Z direction. So if it's not, then press E and Z, so it's locked in the Z direction. Then extrude it something like that. Now again we needed to extrude it, press E to extrude it something like that at this position, and make sure your direction of the extrusion must be in the Z direction. You have to take care in which direction X, Y, or Z you are going to extrude it. So make this extrusion at this position, and then S to scale it and make it smaller. And if you see on the top left corner, you can see how much I am going to scale it. So if I scale it here, and we can also adjust this scale. If you go here on the resize, and you can see the properties of the scale X, Y, and Z, we scale it 0.614. Okay, now again press E to extrude this one and extrude it at this position, something like that. Then again scale it little bit, just smaller value, something like that, and then E to extrude it and make it like that. And here again S to scale it like that, then again E to extrude it and make it something like that. Okay, now we make this simple boss, then shift Z to go to the solid view mode, or you can just simply click here and deselect x-ray, so you are in the solid view. Okay, now again go to the x-ray and make sure you select all of the top vertices. When all of the top vertices are selected, here you can see we have the x here. So R to rotate it and lock the direction in X, and just make it something like that. So make sure you are rotating it in the right axis. So just check for you in which direction you needed to rotate it. So for me, X is lying here, so that's why I press R and then X to rotate it in the X direction. Okay, now move your rotate your view something like that, so you can see which is the middle vertices. So for me, this one is the middle vertices, so select it and then go here on the proportional editing. For the proportional editing, when we activate it, when we rotate or we scale or move vertices, it will also affect the other vertices. If this proportional editing is not selected, if I press G, I am only moving this single vertices. So X ESC to cancel it. So if I activate it now, if I press G to move this vertices, you can see a circle appear here. So all the vertices which are in this circle will be affected when I am moving this single vertices. So we can also rotate the middle mouse button wheel to affect the diameter of this circle, the size of this circle. So when we change this, you can see all the vertices which are in this circle, these are affecting. So just press S to cancel it. Okay, now when this proportional editing is activated, then press G to activate the move, and here I am going to decrease this circle, so only the top vertices will be affected, and then lock this direction in Y. I want to move it in the Y direction, so make it something like that. Okay, then press tab to go to the object mode and hide this, deactivate this toggle x-ray view. Okay, now then just G and Z to move this in the Z direction, something like that. And here we are going to apply this modifier, the subdivision modifier. So go to the modifier properties tab and apply the subdivision modifier. Okay, so we can see how it's making changes for this vase. So here we can, by if you use this subdivision services, it will add a geometry to our object. So you can see when we apply it, it's added more geometries, more cut, more loops, more vertices in our geometry. Then press tab to go to the edit mode, and then press 3 to select the face selection mode, 3, and select this top, and then press X to delete this face. Okay, and here we can see when we added this vertices and subdivision, it will making this these tweaks. So then select this and then press I to insert this face and something like that, and control R to add a loop here and make it something like that, and also press control R, add a loop at this position and make it like that, and also add a loop, control R, move your mouse here and something like that. Okay, now you can see the profile is looking good. I'm also going to add a loop here at Morphometry, something like that. Now you can see it's looking good. You can just try to add some loops and see how your final profile will look. Okay, and here under the levels viewport, I'm going to make it blue. Okay, then go to object mode by pressing the tab and shades mode, and I'm going to apply this scale. Okay, and shades mode. If I go here and make this normals like that, okay, so now this boss is complete, its design is complete. Then just select this boss. Now you can see it's a simple plane, we don't have a thickness here. So go to this modifier tab, modifier properties, add a modifier, and this time we are going to add the solidify. The solidify modifier will add thickness to this model. So select this model, and here you can see the thickness. If I increase it, you can see I am adding this thickness. So value 0.1, 0.05 will be good. So this value is good. Okay, now just apply this modifier and make sure you select this even thickness, so it will distribute the thickness evenly. Okay, so this is the design of the boss, and then press 1 on your numpad, select this part, press G and Z to move it, so it must be on the top of this table like that. And you can see this boss is very big, so as to scale and make it a little bit smaller, and select this and make it also smaller. Okay, then 1 on numpad, G to move it, lock it in Z direction, move it like that. Okay, so this is a simple boss. Now we are going to add a flower into this boss. So shift A. So first select this cylinder. This cylinder is boss. Double click on it and make it boss 1. Okay. Now shift A, mesh, and add a plane, and G to move. Move it in y direction, something like that. Then press tab to go to the edit mode and just zoom pan so you have a good view. So control R to add a loop cut in the middle like that and place it in the middle. Then again control R, activate the loop and add a loop here at this position and move this loop like that. Then again control R to add a loop cut here, press left click, add this loop cut. Now you are in the move position, move it normal to it, so move it like that, and then tap. Okay, then press 1 to go to in the vertices mode selection, then box select these two vertices, or shift and select these two vertices, and X to delete and delete the vertices, and same way select these two vertices and shift to select the other one, and then X to delete and delete these vertices. Now we have this shape. Then go press tab and control A and apply the scale. Now I am going to use the mirror to mirror this plane on the other side. So for this plane, I am going to name change it flower. Okay, then select this plane of the flower, add modifier and add a mirror modifier here. So it will be add a mirror, and now we are adding this mirror about the X axis. So for you can see on which side it's adding the mirror. So just play with this. So when the X is selected, we have the X here. So this plane is here, so it's adding the mirror along this X axis. So that is the theory of it, on which plane you want to add the mirror. Okay, then check this clipping and apply this Sorry, we don't need it to apply this modifier at this time. Don't apply this modifier. If you applied it, control Z, go backside. So select this flower and press tab to go to the edit mode, and then something like that. Make it in the right view according to you, or you can also press 7 to go to the top view. Okay, then select these two vertices and G to move it. And first deactivate this proportional. If it's activated, deactivate it. Select these two vertices, then G to move, and move it in Y direction like that. And select these two vertices and G to move, and move it in Y direction. Something like that. Then select this this vertices and G to move in Y direction like that, and this vertices G to move in Y direction, something like that. Okay, then select this vertices G to move and move it in Y direction, and then select this vertices and press G twice, so it will move normal along the normal. So G, so now you can see it's moving normal too, like that. And also G to move it in the Y direction, make it something like that. Okay, now if I go to the object mode by pressing the tab and apply the subdivision modifier, you can see we have a shape something like that. Okay, so this is the shape which we achieve now. And now apply this mirror modifier and apply this and make the level viewpoint viewport to 2 and apply this modifier. Okay, now select this one and press tab to go to the object mode, edit mode, and here we needed to go to the edge mode by pressing 2 or select the this mode here, the edge mode. You can make it activated by going here or press 2 on your keyboard. Okay, now we needed to select this complete loop in the middle, the edges in the middle, sorry. So press Alt and select this complete loop. By pressing the Alt, when you select one loop, it will select the whole loop around it. Okay, now activate this proportional, this one, and G, and move it in Z, then press Z, and make sure your circle is like that, and then just move little bit below like that. Okay, now we needed to select this middle loop again, Alt and select it, and then G to move it and make it smaller like that. And now select this point. So to select this vertices, press 1 on your keyboard, so you will be in the vertices selection mode, or you can also activate it here. So now we needed to select this middle vertices, this one, and then proportional rating G to move it and move it in Z direction like that, and make your cursor something like that. So this circle must be bigger, and it must not include the left and right points, something like that, and just move it like that. Now you can see we have a shape something like that. Then press tab to go to the object mode and shade smooth it, and then go to the modifier and add a solidify modifier, and at this point we just add a smaller thickness 0.005, and then go here to this object data properties by selecting this one, go to normals and auto smooth, activate it. Okay, so now we have this something like a leaf, and we needed to copy it. So shift D to duplicate this object, and when you press shift D, it will be the object will be duplicated, but now you are in the move, you can move it. So then press left click to deselect this movement of this. We have the copy, but when you left click it, so you see we make a copy flower 1, and here we have flower 2. How we did it, I am going to back So only one flower, select it, shift D to duplicate it, and then you can see this this flower object is is moving. So to deactivate it, its movement, and move it to its initial position, just right click. So now the object is duplicated, we can see it, but it's in its initial position. Now make sure it's selected, then press R to rotate it in the Z direction, like that. So here one thing we have to do. So one thing we have to do, so Control C to move backward when we have a single copy, then select this object and then tab to go to edit mode, and here select this point, this single point. Now what we want, our 3D cursor to move into this position, so when we rotate this model, it will rotate our object according to this 3D cursor. So that's why we needed the 3D cursor here. So at this point it has this location. So how we can do that? By pressing the shift S. Now this tab, you can see it's activated. So shift x to activate this selection, so you can move your cursor or object. It has different options here. So what now what we want our 3D cursor to move into this selection. So here we have the option selection to cursor. If we select it, this point will be moved to our 3D cursor, and here we have option cursor to select it. So if I select it, it will move the cursor to this selection. So cursor to select it, when I select it, now the cursor is here. So now we can use this cursor and we can rotate this model. Okay, then tab to go to the object mode, and here when you go here, you see transform pivot point. So now what we want affect everything according to this 3D cursor. So make sure you selected 3D cursor. Okay, now shift D to copy it, then place it into its initial position by right clicking, and then R to rotate it, and then Z to rotate it in the Z direction, and now you can see it's rotating like that. And here we are going to press 180, so it will be something like that. It's now it's we can see it's just mirrored. Okay, now select these two, and then R to rotate. Then select these two, and then Shift B to make a duplicate, and then we are going to press right click to move it to its initial position, and now R to rotate it in Z direction, press Z, and now it's rotating like that, and then type 90, so it's rotated 90 degree. So okay, now again select these four. If you select B for boss selection on your keyboard, it's selecting all, then shift D to copy it, then place it in its initial position by right clicking, and then R to rotate, and rotate it in Z direction, press Z, and here you can see you are rotating it like that. So rotate it like that. Okay, then press G to move it little bit above on the below leaves of this flower, then press G to move it in Z direction, something like that. Okay, now we have a simple flower, then press shift A and add a UV sphere, and then S to scale, and scale it something like that, then scale it in Z direction, S and Z, and make it something like that. Here you can see it, then shade smooth it, and then scale it, make it little bit. Little bit smaller. Okay. Now this is the simple flower. Then boss, press B to boss selection, and select all of these flower, and then M to move it into a new collection. So select all of these objects, then press M to move it into a new collection. So we are generating a new collection, then new collection, and name it flower. So now we have this simple flower. So make sure everything is selected, then G to move it and place it here at this position, then 7 on numpad, so you have the top view, then G to move it and place it here at this position like that, and then 3, so you have the right side view and G and Z and make it like that. Now here you can see on the transfer pivot point we selected the 3D, so if we apply the scale it will do the operation according to the position of this 3D cursor. So we needed to select the individual origins because we want to scale this object. So press 3 on your numpad, so you have this view, and now box select all of these objects, make sure all of them are selected, then shift and then select this middle, so this one is not selected, this sphere is not selected, make sure, and then control J to join all of these objects. Okay. So make sure this sphere is not selected, then control or this one J, control J. Not joining them. Okay, so select all of these objects, control A to apply the scale, then 3 on numpad, select all of these and make sure you did not select the middle one. Okay, now we just want them to make a single flower, and here apply this modifier. Okay, now we needed to select all of these and S to scale it, so make it scale it according to their individual origins. Okay, select this one, select this object, we have to shift this origin in the middle, so select this object and then right click and set origin to center of mass, so it has the center here, it will change the origin in the center. Now press S to scale, select this object, select this flower, shift select this one and S to scale, something like that. And then G and Z to move it in its position. Okay, so here we have this flower and we needed to select this object and then shift S, so we can change the 3D cursor into this object in the origin of this object, so cursor to selected. Now this cursor is move here. Now press shift A and we are going to add a curve, and make sure you select this curve and add a path. I have a lot of curves here, and because I activated the add-on which is about the extra curve, so curve and add this curve. Now we needed to move this curve in the rotate it by pressing R and Y to rotate it and make it a vertical curve, then press 90, so we have like that, then press 3 on numpad and then G to move this curve and lock it in Z direction, so we have this curve like that. And then just I'm going to hide this boss and 3 on numpad, and we can see we have this curve, and then G and press tab, so you are in the edit mode, just edit this curve, Select this point on the top vertices. G to move. Deactivate this proportional. G to move in Z direction and make it like that. It's just touching this bottom point, this bottom of this flower. Okay, and here we can just G to move and make it like that. Something like that. Okay, now go to the object mode and make sure this is selected. Go to the this object data properties of this curve, and here under the geometry we are going to bevel it and give some lenticle thickness. Okay, it's good. Now just show this pass. Okay, now select this one, these three objects, and then just shift D to copy it and make another copy at this position. So just make sure it's not crossing this object, then select all of these three, G to move it in the Y direction like that. So make sure it's not crossing. Select this one, R to rotate. Just make it a good scene according to you. Okay, now we just created this vase and two flowers, and here we are going to create another vase, and then we are going to create a oranges in this vase. Okay, now just shift S to move the cursor toward origin. So the cursor will be moved here. Then we are going to add another cylinder. So shift A to add a cylinder, and then G to move it and move it in the Y direction at this place, and then G to move it and move it in the Z direction by pressing the Z. Then press 3 on numpad and tab to go to the edit mode, and shift Z so you have the X-ray view. Now we are going to work on this cylinder, so just zoom in, zoom out, or pan it in the right position. Okay, so this position is good for me, and we are in the X-ray view. So select top vertices, and now simply we are going to use the extrude and scale to make this another vase. Okay, so G to move it and move it in the Z direction, and make it something like that. And here we have this and this vertices, and now just right click and shift Z, and we needed to delete this top face. So 3, so you have in the face selection, select this face, X to delete this face. Now shift Z, so you have the vertex selection mode. Then press 3 on numpad so you can see it from the right side. Then press 1, so you are in the vertex select mode, and then select the top vertices. Make sure when you are selecting it, you are in the X-ray view. Okay, now E to extrude this one, and here we extruded it, but we want this extrude to go to its initial position. Then right click. Now we extruded, but this extrusion is on the initial position. Then S to scale it, and scale it something like that. Then E to extrude it, and press Z so this extrusion go in the Z direction and make it like that. Okay, then E to scale it, and now E to extrude it. Now this extrusion, we want it in its initial position. Then right click. Okay, and then S to scale it, so you have it like that. Then again E to extrude it, and press Z so you are extruding in the Z direction, and make this extrusion something like that. Okay, now press E to extrude it in Z direction. Press Z and place it like that, and S to scale it something like that. Then E to extrude it and press Z so you are extruding in Z direction. Then make it here at this position, and S to scale it like that. then E to extrude it, and press Z. So you are extruding in the Z direction, and go here and press S to scale it a little bit like that. Then again E to extrude it and press Z. So you are extruding it in Z direction. Then you just place it like that, then S to scale it like that. Okay, so again E to extrude it and press Z. So you are extruding it in Z direction and make it like that, and S to scale it something like that. Then E to extrude it and select Z. So you are extruding it in Z direction and make it something like that. Smaller value. And S to scale it like that. And here again we are going to E to extrude it and place this extrusion into initial position, left click, and then just press E and Z to extrude it in the Z direction like that. Then again E to extrude it and place this extrusion into its initial position. Then S to scale it inside, make it smaller like that. Then again E to extrude it, and this time extrude it at this position, and then S to scale it and make it bigger like that. Then again E to extrude it in Z direction and extrude it at this position, and then just extrude it a little bit value. Okay, now we have this something like that. It's very bigger. We will scale it, so don't worry about it. S to tab and shift Z, so we can see what we achieved, something like that. Okay, shift Z to go to the x-ray, then press 3, and here we are going to make sure you are in the vertex selection. Select the bottom vertices, go to the edit mode by pressing the tab, select this bottom vertices, and G to move it in the Z direction, something like that. Okay, here we are going to add some loop cuts, so that we will add some design in this object. Okay, so get ready. How you can add the loop cut? Control R is the shortcut, and the other way is that we just select this one and add a loop cut, but the shortcut key work very efficiently, so it's better if you practice this, how you can add the control R and what happen. So let me tell you. So if you press the control R, it will activate the loop tool, and when you move your cursor in the position, it will give you a view. So it's telling we are going, the Blender is going to add the loop here. So when this is here, now you want to add the two loop, just move your middle mouse wheel, so it will make it two. Then when you press the left click, now it is the loop are activated, added, but it also activated the move tool. So now you don't, if you don't want this move movement and you want it, place it into its initial position, so just right click. So it's added, and by right clicking we did not place it in another location. Then just press and make sure these vertices are selected, press S to scale it like that. Again control R and add loop cut here, and I'm going to add 3 loop cut, and left click to place it, and now it's, they are moving normal to it, and then right click to place it, and then just press S and scale it a little bit. And we are also going to add some loop cut here. So control R, add 6 loop cut at this position. Control R, add loop cuts here, place it in the position. Control R, add a loop cut, and then just move this loop cut at this position. Control R, add a loop cut and make it at this position. Okay, then shift Z. So now you can see you added some geometry to your body. Then tab to go to the object mode, then go here, apply this subdivision modifier. Now you can see how the subdivision modifier is working. Then just go to the, press tab, go to the edit mode, then 3 to select the face selection and select this face, and press I to insert this face, something like that. Then again I to insert it, Okay. Now we added these loops here. So we are going to extrude some loops to give our design in this vase, for this vase. So I am going to select the three. So you have in the face selection mode, then press Alt and click here. So you can select this complete loop like that. Then Shift and select this loop. Then Shift Alt select this loop and we are good. Okay, then E to extrude this one, but for this one we are okay. First I am so make sure the pivot transform, make sure you are in the individual origin. So you just you selected these loops, these faces of the loops, and then just press S, and when you press X, it's scaling. But we want to scale it, but we don't want to scale it in the Z direction. So press Shift Z. No, it will only scale it in the X and Y direction. It will not scale it in the Z direction. Just add this something like that, and same for these loops. So Alt select this loop. And then Shift and select this loop, and then Shift to select this loop. And here I am going to press E to extrude it. Then place the extrude in its initial position. Then S to scale it. And now we want to scale it in the X and Y. We don't want to scale it in the Z direction. So how we can stop the extrusion? The sorry in the scale in a axis. So Shift Z. Now you can see the X and Y axes are shown here. So now it's only extruding the scaling it in the X and Y direction, something like that. And then Shift Alt and select this loop and E to extrude it. Then place it in its position. Then E to scale it and only scale in Z X and Y. So Shift Z, and now we can. Sorry, S to scale it and Shift Z to scale only in the X and Y direction. Make it something like that. Then tab to see the preview and shade smooth it. And we have something like that. And then apply this modifier and add the solidify modifier. And here give thickness a smaller value, something like that. Okay, then apply it. Now we have this vase, then S to scale it, make it like that. Then press 3 on your numpad G and place it here. Okay, now for this vase we are going to create a simple orange. So Shift A, and we are going to add a UV sphere, and then G to move it here in this position, S to scale it, something like that. And we are going to select this sphere, Control A to apply the scale, then tab to go to the edit mode, then select this top vertex by pressing 1. So you are in the vertex selection mode. Select this vertex, then activate the proportional editing, then G to move it in Z direction, and make this circle little bit smaller. Like that. Okay, then pan it, and so you can select this bottom vertices, select it, then G to move, and Z, something like that. Okay, now this is this where we added for the orange. The orange is not like symmetrical, so just select some vertices and just move some vertices so it's not in the shape of not totally symmetrical. Random vertices you can. Okay, we are not going to add some details, so tab, press tab. So you are in the object mode, then shades mode, and you can see we ha you have a simple orange here. So when this is selected, press 7 on your numpad and g to move it here at this position, and then 1, and then select this one, shift z, so you can see in the x-ray view where you are going to place it. G to move it and move it in the z direction and place it something like that, and then s to scale it, then g to move it like that, then shift z, so you have in the solid view, and then D shift D to duplicate it and place it like that, so you have two oranges, and then press 7 on your numpad and shift D, place it here, shift D, place it here, so now these two are touching it, then just select it, press 3 on your numpad, G to move it here, then shift z, so you have in the wireframe view 3, go to the right view, g to move it, and z, and make sure it's not touching, but place it here, then select this one, d to duplicate it, shift d, and place it here, press 3 on your numpad, d to shift D, we make this duplicate, and then just make sure you place it just on the above, and also select it, D, G to move it, and make sure you place it here. Okay. Now just make sure you hide, show this flower, and we are going to select all of these oranges, and Control J to make it one copy. This sphere, it's for orange. Okay, this is the simple scene, we just produce it, and now I am going to add the textures and everything to make this scene look good. So just add shift A to add a plane, and we are going to scale this plane like that, then go to select this plane, press tab and press 2, so you are in the white selection mode, E to extrude this, and Z to lock it in Z direction, and then we needed to bevel this this edge, so Control B is shortcut key to bevel it, so first select this one, then Control B to bevel it, and here you can see we are beveling it, then rotate the wheel, so you add the segments to make it a round shape like that, then tab to go to the object mode and shade smooth it. Okay, so here we have this scene, and now we are going to add the materials. So for this background, I am going to go to the material, add new material, and this material we're going to change it back, and this one its color we are going to make it black. Okay, so to see it you have to go to the render. Okay, so it's black, and here we can also have to activate this light, so you can see the light here, and for this light select this light, and we are going to make it a area light and increase its size, then select this light and then shift D to duplicate it and place it here, and then R to rotate it, so this yellow is pointing like that on the top, G to move it and lock it in the Y direction and move it here on this place. Okay, now this setup is good, some simple lighting, you can add more lights and tweak these by changing the position, we can also increase its power, we can also change the color, so it's little bit, not too much, just smaller value. Okay, now I am going to select this orange and add a press new and add this material for the orange and go to shading. And here you can see, go to render view, here we needed to add some nodes. So make sure go to the add-on preference, go to add-on, and this node wrangler is activated. This is the default add-on. So if it's activated, then you can add this nodes. Okay, so we have our principal BSDF and the material output. Here we are going to add shift A and then search noise texture. So add this node and then again shift A and color ramp, add this node. So for the for this this factor, sorry, this color to this one and this color to this base color, connect this, and we are going to make a simple material. Then move this bar at the middle, and also move this bar at the middle. And here for the first bar, we are going to make it like that and select the orange, something like the orangish, like that. And then select the other tab and select this color. And here we are going to put the hex value E76233, something like that. And just increase this scale to 78. Change these values and see. I'm going to reference values to 1. Okay, this will be a simple material, and then shift A to add the node bump. And here we are going to use the factor to hide, and this normal to connect with this normal. And you can see we added these bumps, so its value is larger. Make it something like that. And for the go to the render properties and render engine, I am going to select cycle, so we can see it in the cycle render and see the material if it's making sense. Changing these values will filter the result, and we need the color, the match of this color, which is good for us. I am also going to change this roughness here. Okay, it's something good. You can also see the videos how you can achieve the color of this orange. So for me, I think it's good. Okay, to select this was add new material and metal, and simply select this color and make it a little bit grayish, and increase this metal value to 1, decrease this, so it's something very shiny. Here you can also this reflection of this orange is, so increase this roughness. And then I'm going to select this vase, add a new material. This is for the vase, and basically I'm going to go to the layout, and for the layout I'm going to go to the material, select this vase and add a blue color here. Increase roughness. Something like that. And then this flower, add a new material and add yellowish. Also select this flower and like that. Then select this middle object and make the color of this one is good. string like that. Also select this, and this one is material 2. Then select this meshes, add a new material. You can change the name of the material. So for this one, make it green. So this one, and make it green. And for this table, we are going to make it something sky blue. Then press 0 on your numpad so you have in the camera view. Then press N and here go to view and lock this one camera to view. So now you when you rotate, it will not rotate the camera, it will only rotate your scene. I am going to move this plane G and move it in Y direction. Something like that, and select this camera, select the camera. I'm going to show this camera. Select this camera under the properties, increase its focal length. So adjust it according to you. And now you can see created this beautiful scene by using simple tools of modeling in Blender. So it's only about the practicing. If you practice it, you can achieve this goal. So I'm going to just little bit so you can see it from the top. Okay, so now for the render setting, select cycle if you GPU, and for me I'm going to make it GPU render. And for the deactivate this noise, and for the render sample I'm going to place it 100 so it will render fast. Make sure you select the denoising and render image. So now it will render this image. So thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Goodbye, and please subscribe my channel.